today, and man, couldn't get through any doors. Quite frustrating.
Those are extras?
Yeah.
Alrighty, your work for you. Figure it's fairly appropriate.
Alright, this is the pipe thing I think I'm gonna shoot up.
Alrighty.
I'm gonna get ready for it.
Hit me.
Right here. Ready? I'm gonna brace.
Alright, get that wide stance. Nice horse
stance. Ready. I'm ready.
Yes.
Keep backing up. Keep backing up.
He is. Again.
Keep backing up. Keep doing it.
I think we fucked up.
Never got your moment.
I never got my dude. I was bracing for him.
So he was officially terminated for all intents and purposes from the police department. And there's a couple things that go into that. First and foremost, we have a resignation policy.
Give her some powder.
Brian Salem, search warrant.
What the fuck?
Please face away from me. Put your hand.
What are you guys doing?
Sir. Face away from me. Reporter, can you step out for a second?
Absolutely. It was actually just crushed up ketamine. On
okay. Chief Taylor, can you face away from me? Place your hands behind your back.
I want to see this so-called search warrant before I'm complying with any fucking thing you're talking about.
Heal up a boy.
Please, just face away from me.
Remember what you.
I'm not doing anything until I see this so-called search warrant. And you can't force me to, so present that paperwork, and we'll do this.
All right, well, we have a warrant for your arrest, by the FIB.
By the FIB, or the FBI? Which one is it?
FBI.
Fizzle, do you have any antiviral cream?
All right, can you face away?
It's going up.
Yeah, give me a second.
Going up?
Yeah.
I'm going to toss you into this fucking fire.
You better not.
It's looking really tempting. How much percent are you at?
Huh?
What's your virus percent?
Low enough. Give me the stuff.
It's already gotten into his brain.
Give me the stuff.
Low enough.
Can you face away?
Yeah, give me a second. Making a phone call.
Let me
I have my right to make a phone call. Give me a second.
You got your right to make a phone call?
Give it to me.
Now I'm just gonna use it. I have to use it now.
Funny you guys have automatic weapons in a fucking police station.
Motherfucker.
Comical.
No, stop. He's crazy.
I don't know which one of you to believe.
He's insane.
So in the story of Bone Francois.
Such penmanship.
I was supposed to say, it's obviously just typed up and it's not even in the line. So
yeah.
Who writes like that? Is that the default script?
Hold that comment to the end, please.
Raccoon universe. said fuck that.
And they were like, okay, we need to fucking, we need new peeps on this.
Oh my.
The only way to up it was having Daniel Craig hitting the balls repeatedly with a rope.
This will not be continued. I'm just blowing off time until Tarkov lives. I'll see you guys in a week.
Santana, let me come watch you. Ernest, tell him to wave me and Scar in. Are you serious, man? I gotta see this shit myself. I'll talk to you later. I see him. I'm sitting outside the door. I'll talk to you later, man.
Actively on the phone, but where's this arrest warrant at? Still waiting for you to produce it. Last I checked, you are not able to serve warrants without documentation of such, and I'm not going to take a verbal order.
Oh, there's an agent outside right now. There is an agent outside.
Please, I'd love to chat with him.
All right.
Hey, 110, you want to come to the PD when you're free? Copy, thanks. Talk to this old agent. What's up, agent?
What's up? We're having Tufan fly in. He should be in here any second.
Cool. Can't wait.
Pick up for me.
You guys do realize this is a fucking police station, right? What, you think I'm gonna try to shoot six of you? God damn, you guys are funny. You want to show me this arrest warrant or begin to tell me the fucking first thing about this? Because I'm all ears.
I don't have a name. How's it going, my fellow FBI agent?
What's up, man? I don't know. You want to tell me? Because I have a fucking squad of armed state troopers interrupting a meeting I had with press.
I believe Ram might know what's going on. He should be in here in a second. I'm just here to assist his needs.
Cool.
Who do we have right here to my right?
Yeah.
Okay, great. Nice to see you. You're looking good, brother. You're looking real good, brother. I'm guessing this is about you, Mr. Brown Taylor. We do have you surrounded here. No, I don't know how hostile we need to be with the weapons, but...
Yeah, I'm not sure what's going on. I don't know if they understand, like, I'm a police officer, and if they think I'm gonna try to shoot, what is there, 5, 6, 7 of you within line of sight? I don't know. I think, I know state police is known for being fucking overzealous, but... This is even a far cry from that. Got handgun, assault rifle, what was an SMG, assault rifle over there. Got two handguns on your guys' hips. I don't know what the fucking worry is, man. I'm getting ready to fly out.
All right, well, I'm gonna get ready for Ram. He should be in here in a second, and then he'll tell you what's going on here. Because he obviously leads state police here, so they obviously have a reason to be here. So I'm waiting for Ram to come and he'll take it away. So let's give him a second. He should be here in a second.
Right. Maybe Ram should have planned it fucking better and been here, shouldn't he?
Well, listen, man, I'm here. I'm not really sure what I'm supposed to be doing, but I'm just talking to you, man. So hopefully he'll be here soon. Should be walking in.
Santana, if you keep edging closer to you, I might just give you a kiss.
I'm too scared. All right, man. You're under arrest.
Okay.
You have the right to remain silent. Everything say can or will be.
Can I see this search warrant? Or arrest warrant or anything?
Sure
or is this
FBI,
just all.
I'm pretty sure
the
FBI.
The FBI isn't explaining fucking anything, so.
I'm pretty sure the FBI have it for you.
I'm all ears.
I'm waiting for our last. I'm waiting for Ram to come in here before we start talking.
Are cuffs really necessary, guys? He handcuffed the fucking police chief in the station.
I don't think we need the cuffs sent in. I mean, come on, what's he gonna do, run away?
Are you fucking shitting me right now? This is just salt on a fucking wound.
So I believe this starts, something said to an officer, J-High in City, something you said. Ram has more details on it because I know he's talked to you in an email. Now I've kind of just come in here flying into the city, just aiding this whole scene we have going on here, but he will have more details. I wish I could tell you more. I don't know the full story. No, Ram does. So I'm going to see. I'm going to go around the corner and see if he can come in here and fucking tell you what's going on. Okay.
Yeah, you mind uncuffing me? Because this is fucking insulting is what this is.
He's chief police. He doesn't need cuffs. I'll be right back.
This fucking poor execution of a warrant, guys. You gotta tune up your fucking skills. You got 19 fucking guys and not a single one has any fucking clue what's going on. Coffee, thanks. Got a shit show by the press room.
Oh no, the sandwich.
You should go ahead and start typing up a template for like a false report or a corruption thing, because I think I'm about to poke a whole lot of fucking holes in whatever is going on here. So, might have a juicy story for you, sir.
Bonjour, what the fuck's happening?
Well, state police here is armed to the fucking nines, man, and they had me at gunpoint a couple minutes ago saying they have a warrant, but not a single one fucking knows a single thing that's going on. So I mean, it's
excuse me.
Yeah, I know, right? Couldn't tell you, man. As much as I love Santana, he still has a fucking Class 2 in his hand. Not sure what he expects to go on here.
There's
a
no
bloodbath.
No warrants out here.
Yeah, that's a good fucking question, man.
Maybe state troopers need to watch the MVP before they act.
Yeah, well, I mean, state police is known for being pretty fucking useless, so. This is just another day in the life.
If Class 2s aren't authorized,
I hear that.
Sorry, and you are? Who are you?
Sergeant. Penny, you know who I am.
Yeah, this is Lockshift. I guess he's a traitor, I'm not sure.
So, what the fuck's going on, Lockshift?
Ooh. I'm enjoying myself in the wasteland.
Nobody gonna. Ooh.
Yeah, right, dude. That this has literally been the last fucking 15 minutes, damn near. Oh, criminal. Too fucking funny. Here, I'll match you, Santana. Look at my M4. I just don't have an illegal suppressor on the end of mine. That's the only difference between yours and mine.
It's a tactical suppressor.
Ka-chow. Fucking with him.
He just ain't. What?
Okay, so what's Press doing here as well?
Oh, well, I was actually having a chat with him. Moments before. They literally walked in like 30 seconds into my meeting.
Let me reenact what I think just happened.
Yeah, please do.
Am I correct? No, anyone gonna answer? Everyone have chainsaws here?
You're munching really loud.
Yeah, so what happened? I'll reenact it for you. So myself and this gentleman were having the beginning of a chat, and about four state police go, "Hey, Brian Taylor," in like their deepest voices possible. It was comical. See, they say I have a search warrant, and then that turns into an arrest warrant. And then I get cuffed and then released, and now I've been here for 15 minutes waiting for the FBI. So I don't know if they expect me to have all night, man, but man's got to eat. I'm fucking hungry.
I didn't even know we have FBI. Who's FBI?
Yeah, I didn't know they existed, but there's one there and one, I think, around the corner. He may have poofed, I'm not sure.
Surely FBI terminals are the same as police terminals, and we can see the same warrants.
Yeah, I don't even know if they have a terminal, to be honest, because they don't really do operations in the city, was my understanding, but...
There is no information saying that FBI even existed in the city.
Say that again? You kind of cut out.
There was no information that FBI even existed in the city.
Yeah, I think they're a new agency as of 15 minutes
Shouldn't
ago.
Shouldn't have some type of government official said, hey... Well, we have a new agency now.
Here, you would think as much.
You guys can now apply for this. And since when were automatic transfers allowed, not just?
Yeah, dude. Whole lot of holes getting poked in this one.
Damn, I'd love to be able to transfer at will. Like, 1 second I'm a trooper, 1 second I'm a police officer, 1 second I'm a paramedic, 1 second I'm a firefighter. So what even is fucking going on?
God, dude, I don't know. Not sure.
Is this turning into a government situation, or is it still a situation as it is?
You know as much as I. This is what it's been for 20 minutes, and counting.
I'm gonna make a joke here.
Please do.
I can turn it into a government situation if you want.
That's funny. I'll give it to you.
Yeah, I'm not gonna though. I'm not dumb enough.
G'day, you can put your damn pistol away.
No.
Excuse me?
It's Freddy.
Bon, can you clarify what's going on here? Hungry guy.
Telling we're not gonna go back like the 1700s where one sheriff department goes up to another sheriff department going, "You're in my town now, get the fuck
out."
Don't
point that gun to me, sir.
I didn't. I pointed it at the door.
Everything will be very clear in a moment. Just give it some time.
I pointed it at the door. That's the door. You're not right there.
Okay. Well, I'm about ready to take a 10-7 meal break.
You're there.
I was about to do that 15 minutes ago before getting rudely interrupted. If I'm getting deported out of the city, just cut to the chase.
You haven't done anything to be deported.
Okay, Mr. Taylor, I'm sorry to have you waiting so long. Ram is still in his head. But we do have an arrest warrant for you. I can read it off to you, or I can send it via email if you'd like to see it.
Yeah, please send it. I'd love to see it.
All right, brother. I'm going to send it your way now.
I appreciate you. I don't remember breaking any laws. I mean, I don't know what. There's a red light here and there.
I'm also confused about another thing. Since this is an LSPD state, wouldn't LSPD carry out the warrant along with FBI, not state trooper?
Yeah, Colonel O and I did agree that we would hand it over to a jurisdiction, but
this,
you know, all rules are out the window.
This warrant is right from Matthew Judge Heimer.
From who?
Judge Matthew Heimer.
Okay. Well, no, we made an interagency agreement that wherever the person in reference to the warrant is located is the agency that handles it. So should be an LSPD thing, but I mean, again, I think all rules are out the window. We got class twos. We have a 9-to-1 fucking officer ratio.
Okay.
I'm not expecting anything by the book.
All right. That's completely fine. If you look at your emails, I went ahead and showed you that warrant. So I'm going to let the SASP boys take it away after this. And then I guess you'll be talking to Ram head up here soon whenever he's back in his head.
So
he just sent me that.
Real quick. When the warrant says malfeasance and negligence, those are not laws.
Well, he wanted to talk to you because of the negligence. He's seeing a lot of cops, lower level cops going around, particularly making the city more dangerous with civilian interactions, depending on what's going on in the city. That's what I've heard. I don't know the full story. I'm sure when you talk to Ram, he'll be able to, you know, say everything clearly and describe exactly what's going on and what he sees is wrong.
Okay. Well, tell
he'll have all
fucking
the information
superhero
for
Ram to email me when he's ready to have that conversation. But
I'm
not sitting around here all day waiting for him.
I'll relay the message to him. All right.
Great. Because last I checked, those two are not laws, and nothing said in the last 20 minutes is even remotely related to a law.
So those two are not laws. However, they do relate to the laws broken by the LSPD, as well as the dangerous situations they've been putting the rest of the civilians of this fucking glorious state.
Yeah, okay, go ahead and clarify. What laws have been broken? Please educate me.
I need to educate you? I thought you were the chief.
I'm the one not understanding an arrest warrant, so educate me. Because this is this would not stand in court. Not a fucking chance would this stand in court.
That's why you have the right to remain silent.
I'm not worried about self-incrimination.
Get a lawyer. Right, there's no debate right now. I don't understand why you...
Oh, no, there is a debate, because right off the bat, this is
a
very clearly rushed fucking warrant.
Nah, that's not rushed.
Yeah, we're all just taking our sweet time.
The Rangers got this.
Seconds ago.
I'm going to stand outside and make sure I don't do shit.
That's what it looks like. I would guess in the last couple hours. Yeah.
Alright, SASP...
This is a fucking joke.
State police wants to take Mr. Chief Brian Taylor away. So he can talk with Ram in the police station. That would be great.
Yeah, tell him to email me. When the man has a fucking courage to email me back, I would love to chat with him and talk about how a warrant should be made.
Okay, are you going to be flying out there, Taylor?
If I can. I mean, I've been trying to get off shift for about 30 minutes now, and there's only so long I can be held over, if you understand what I mean.
Okay, can you just give me, like, one more second? I'm re-home.
Please.
Okay,
it's funny how he can teach somebody else about a warrant, but he can't teach his fucking cadets.
Or it looks like it was made by a 14-year-old. Personally wanted for arrest by me. Interesting.
I mean, he isn't a cop, so he doesn't know.
Police made an oath in due form. That this barely is English. This looks like this was made by a high school student.
All right, Brian, so I have some more unfortunate news for you, as I'm going to be the deliverer of bad news. Like I said, I don't have all details presented with me today. This was more of a government issue, and from now on, you will no longer be the chief of the PD. You are now fired from the department. If you have any questions or concerns, please refer to Ram. This is a government issue that in all votes from government have voted you out of chief of PD.
Okay, well, it was a pleasure. I will see you guys on the other side.
Brother, we appreciate you, man. I'm sorry this happened to you, but it is what it is, man.
Well, you know,
when you
have somebody like Ram who has hurt feelings, I figured this was inevitable. I'm not quite shocked by this. So,
okay, well, as I said, man, you can email who you want to email and talk about it. There's more government that can talk to you about it, but I have to back up, you know. The votes and choices that are made.
Now,
anyways, here's a wildlife Matthew Fawn. Matthew, would you like to say anything? I just delivered the bad news to Mr. Brian Taylor here. If you are speaking, we cannot hear you.
Yeah, I can't hear him.
Anything you want to add on before Brian flies out?
Corporal.
Okay. Anything or no?
Nothing.
What's going on?
I'm just trying to see if
Matthew wants to say. I don't know if he's trying to speak or something's, you know, blocking, or just want to make sure.
I don't see him here.
Nope, I think everything was pretty directly stated in the warrant.
Alrighty. Well, I guess that is going to conclude this whole little warrant we had here. They can't take you to PD, or you can choose to take your flight out of the city, either one.
Yeah, I'll just take my flight. I already noticed that. I don't have a job anyway, so it doesn't really matter.
Okay, bro. Alright, I'm sorry to deliver you bad news, man. Obviously, I'm not trying to be the bad guy here, but it just, things happen. It is what it is, and hopefully further actions won't happen.
Figured you stand up for what you believe in, and it kind of fucks you over. So, whatever, man. I'm not butthurt about it.
Alrighty, brother. You still have a great night, man. Peace out. Get fucked by the law.
Well, get fucked! Get the fuck out of here! Dave Chappelle, robot, zombie, robot.
U.S. Marshal Tom C. approves his message.
Yeah, where the motherfucking LSPD dudes was over here talking about shit? What's good now? Go change your fucking clothes.
Calm your shit, dude.
Nah, ain't no calm as shit.
Alright.
Yo, J-Roll will get this press conference going. Let's go. I'll be professional as fuck, too. Let's get it.
We're more than happy to talk to you, if you'd like. Okay.
Hey, Chief, come up here. So what am I changing my uniform to? Because someone just came up to me and said change uniform, but nothing to what to.
Hey, bro, you just call, just type me in where you want it. All right, go open the door. Yo, put your class 2 away, bro. We don't need that no more.
Yeah, we're good. I see you rolling. Just give us a second. We're going to let the general public who decided to show up.
All right, so Ram, talk about him getting fired. You're also going to talk about how we got a new heat department.
Shut up for a second.
And then talk about all the training and all that other shit that we're getting ready to implement to really make sure that this city's going to pop. You know what I'm saying? Let them know. And then if you need me to talk about heat or just the training aspect, let me know. Just type me in. I'm here, coach.
To add on anything, unfortunately, today, Chief Brian Taylor has stepped down from his position after he was fired from the LSPD. It's sad to see, you know, a big figure in the city like the chief of LSPD leave, but, you know, this just states that, you know, anyone can make mistakes, and sometimes your mistakes aren't able to be fixed. So, you know, the LSPD will be working hard, Ram. Are you going to take them on their SASP, or, you know, what do you think are the further further events that are going to happen here?
All right. At this time, we're going to go ahead and make our comment and then open to questions afterwards. Tonight, as most of you know, former Chief Brian Taylor, was arrested for malfeasance, negligence, and then was charged an extra resisting arrest. His negligence has gone on for too far. We tried to get him to work with us for the most part. Unfortunately, he is damn near impossible to reach in emails, which is not something we look for in our local police department. With that being said, after the complete and blatant disrespect of the San Andreas State Police, it was at that time that we decided to move forward with the FBI and the marshal to my right to remove him from his position as the chief of police and thus disband the LSPD going forward and merge it into one department. To go into details of the charges at hand is malfeasance, and the definition of that is the unlawful wrongdoing of a government official. And his wrongdoing mainly would be the blatant and utmost disrespect for a lot of cadets and SASP troopers, and as well as his disrespect to me, telling me that my troopers were no longer allowed in the city at all. Unfortunately, that's not how it works. It is a state police, and he was lucky enough to get the jurisdiction that he got. Beyond that, his negligence is due to cause of a LSPD officer who has caused bodily harm to multiple people of citizenship, as well as myself during a 1080 pursuit. He wrote it off and decided to, instead of answering questions or answering to that, saying that if he kept or continued to be disrespected, he would bar the SASP from entering the city at all. At that point, we contacted the FBI, got the backing of the entire government body, unanimous, to remove him from his position, willingly or by force. As you can tell, he chose not to step down or take the resignation option. So it had to come to a public arrest. We tried to save face and keep him from the embarrassment, and he chose that route. Going forward, you'll not be dealing with the LSPD in any way, shape, or form. It'll all be troopers from here on out. And the state police will take control of the state in its total area. With that going forward, we are mobilizing a few new departments. To my right, the trooper in green is the wildlife game warden. Hunting and fishing will be regulated. To my left is the Heat Head Supervisor. Heat is the highway enforcement of aggressive traffic. They're the ones that you'll see with the red stripes. First things first is I'll let the game warden speak on his subdivision of my department.
Hey, how everybody doing tonight? Hi, we're doing good. All right. Okay. Besides the news that Superintendent Ram just gave, I'd like to speak on behalf of the Wildlife Department. Just to let you know, very soon, laws for wildlife will be enforced as fishing, hunting, and recreation as well. Those guidelines will be put out eventually, either later tonight or early tomorrow. So be on the lookout for those in the main email server. Besides that, we are hiring for the wildlife. Of course, you have to go through the standard trooper training and then continued wildlife training, which will very soon change. Pretty soon, the training will definitely be more aggressive and better. But I'll let our training officer, Jay High, speak more about that, as well as his new division. Jay High, you want to take the podium?
Thank you, sir. Y'all know who I am. It's Trooper Jay High. I've got two core mottos. The first is leadership. And the second is training. You know, we are going to pride ourselves in providing some actual leadership to these troopers who, you know, patrol the cities, the state, and you as civilians.
You guys shut the fuck up.
Additionally, training. Training is going to be rigorous. It is going to be detailed. And we are going to provide them with the tools necessary to de-escalate, as well as maintain caution for all those around them while making arrests.
One of you SASP dudes come with
or returning fire on suspected criminals who are creating a dangerous situation. With this leadership team that I have here, I am full-heartedly knowing that we can really pull this off. Yeah. And have a better department that serves you as the people. Thank you.
Neil, you're such a fucking idiot. Jesus Christ.
Yo, Chief. Yo, Colonel.
I'm coming.
Woo! Go, Corporal.
Yeah.
At this time, we'll be opening it to questions. Please don't ask questions about things too far in the future, and I can clarify that when it comes to that. If you have a specific question for J-Hi or Fawn, let me know and I'll bring them to the podium. I think EMS was raising his hand first down there, Borelli.
Yep. Now that J-Hi is doing his thing, are we going to race yet? I want to race our squad cars versus yours any day.
Hey, we can always take it to the airport and
right.
Maybe.
Man, we've been playing in this for so long and still ain't done it. We just gotta do it.
Hey, well, you know what? Maybe we can get some of our car dealerships to go ahead and put on an event, and we can get some more people involved, and maybe we can do some laps around the airport. But it'll have to be sanctioned by government, and of course there'll have to be some police supervision, and we could have a good old time.
Hell yeah.
That's it.
All right, who's next?
Yeah.
Go ahead, ma'am.
I just need to speak with a supervisor, 2 seconds outside. Doesn't matter who.
Yeah, what's up?
Corporal Santana. Thank you, man. Alright, yes, sir.
As the dissolving of the LSPD, will old LSPD officers be moved over to the SASP, or will they have to go through the same rigorous application process that it took before to join the SASP?
Yeah, the LSPD officers who were appointed to a supervisor or command role are being transitioned into those roles appropriately as they worked for those ranks within the LSPD. There is a cadet that was promoted as well from probationary officer to trooper. He's over there raising his two hands. He's one of our newest additions to being a full-time trooper.
Yo, congratulations.
Go ahead.
Oh, and well, me and J-Hi can take this. Also this weekend, myself, J-Hi, and the rest of the supervisors will be doing rigorous training with all the current SASP troopers and the new onboarded SASP officers.
Including those in command positions to ensure that we get training above the ground and they understand what the standard is, so that they can help trickle it down as leaders of the SASP.
That's all I had to add.
Okay, yeah, I'll elaborate on that as well. De-escalation is going to be a huge part of our department. We're tired of seeing officers and civilians being shot, whether they're innocent or not. We would prefer not to do that at all if we can bring it down to it. So if we work together as a community, we can move forward in a way that allows us to be able to de-escalate and put our weapons down, and you guys can put your weapons down, and we can just move forward as a community and build only up from here. Continuing questions, who is next?
The other Antonio.
I think Antonio over there.
Yo. Hey, first off, please shout. I'm pretty sure the people in the back of the room can't hear you because you guys aren't shouting. Second, what is going to happen with Chief Taylor, or former Chief Taylor, I should say? Adding on to that, is this some sort of military coup? Because that's what it's looking like. Without a doubt.
No, the complaints of the community has gone on long enough, and I can no longer stand by and watch the community of my state suffer. Unfortunately, the...
Excuse me?
Large amount of tickets and complaints that come against certain LSP officers or the chief himself has gone too far. And at this time, the FIB and the state police have decided that it's better that if we unify under one badge and move forward on training, so that way we can better control our police officers to do better in the community.
Yes, and go ahead, Ram.
I was going to say, Chief Taylor, we're unsure what's next for him. He will spend some time in Bolingbrook if he flies back in. Unlikely he'll fly back in, because this was a rather humiliating feat for him, unfortunately, even though we tried to avoid it. So, at this time, we're unsure.
Yeah, just don't think that, you know, all this happened in, you know, like a week span. This has been issues that have been going on for, you know, the past few months that, you know, FIB, government has been speaking on it for a while, figuring out what we wanted to do. This was our final scene of what, you know, what went down. There's been, you know, numerous issues we had before with the chief, and, you know, we just had to bring those out. And, you know, he wasn't very happy. You know, he ceased to, you know, comply, and also, you know, gave us some bad back talk as well. So, you know, everything is handled the way we wanted it to. And I'll let Ram continue with the questions.
All right. You guys know who was next, so if you guys can go ahead and...
I got a guy over here in a hoodie, right here, white hoodie. Mr. Los Santos.
I think Antonio was next to me.
If you want. All right, okay. Cool. Antonio, what's up?
What's up with the SRT unit now?
Okay. As far as the SRT unit goes, it hasn't really become a necessity at this time. We are looking to build the amount of troopers that we have on the active roster so that way we can move forward properly and properly staff these special divisions and subdivisions. Most importantly, we need more rangers. It's going to be very important that with hunting becoming a more large pastime, that we need people to regulate that appropriately according to law. And J-High and I are the only two HEAT-certified officers besides Captain J-Ho who couldn't make it tonight. But we will update EMS on the SRT team.
Wasn't he just right there?
Okay. Next.
Okay, I just have a question. Since I was arrested by the LSPD quite a bit, and since their practices were like, you know.
What the fuck, man?
Are my charges going to be, like, wiped?
No.
Yeah, no, that's not going to happen, brother.
I just feel like I was wrongfully arrested a lot of times by the LSPD and their corruption and, you know.
So those charges from the LSPD will be staying because they are still charges that are from the department?
I'll speak on that.
Okay.
We'll go ahead and look into them. Try to gather as much body cam or whatever's archived at this time to see if we can't see if your claims of corruption are warranted. And if it is an unlawful arrest, we'll go ahead and drop those charges and those ones only.
It sounds good.
Yeah,
please do not flood me or the FIB with your claims of corruption. I believe in the emails, we'll take it. Just tag one of us and then we'll reach out to you in DM. And
I'm sure you could
personally email you on it.
You could also talk to an officer in city as well about that issue. Gentleman over there in the white hoodie, sorry, I don't know your name.
Yeah, I'm Benjamin.
They should be able to help you with that issue, brother. They'll look into it and see what they can do.
I'd appreciate it, guys.
Nobody saw that. I know y'all all saw it. Shut up. Before
he's
I pull out my MIB
here.
Stick.
It's
keep playing with me.
You're
I'll splash this whole room.
Now listen. He is the man in black.
You damn right.
Oh my god.
Y'all heard about
he's Will Smith in disguise, boys.
Keep playing.
All right. Back to the. All right.
My bad.
Next question.
Hey, us heat officers are kind of wild.
All right. So this is another twofer real quick. Okay. First off, are the former LSPD officers, I won't drop any names, but they know who they are. Are they going to get sensitivity training? Because they take this shit way too seriously.
Ooh, that's a good question.
And second, what do you think will happen if it wasn't anything to do with Taylor at all, and it actually is just something to do with the civilians of the city, and you become the new Taylor?
I'll answer your second question, and I'll let J.I. answer the first one.
Yeah, that second one didn't make sense to me.
He's basically asking if I plan to become Taylor 2.0.
Yep.
The answer is no. I take my job very seriously.
Can you say without a doubt that you will not have any Taylor-esque
I can personally speak for the colonel. I've known him for almost a year now, almost. Yep. And he's a solid dude. He means well, you know. And what he does is he looks out for his own, and he also takes his job seriously.
Oh,
what was your first question?
So my first question is the officers going to be, are they going to be getting sensitivity training because they take this shit way too seriously?
I'm about to put boot to ass with training, okay? Well, I want to make that very clear to everyone in this room. J-Hi is putting boot to ass to ensure that they understand what de-escalation means, escalation of force, as well as sensitivity training when it means arriving on scene and having an actual conversation with a citizen who is calling for our help instead of asking those protruding questions that may lead to an escalated situation. So, yes, we will be handling all of that.
I got one more thing.
Roger.
Are the officers, and this is mostly directed towards LSPD because LSPD had the most problems. There are a couple SASP that had issues, but I don't believe any of them are around anymore. But are officers going to be disciplined correctly? Because one of the issues that one of the main issues that LSPD had is that an officer and the people who do this kind of stuff know who they are. Would do something stupid, say at a bank robbery or on a traffic stop, or when a person is running and gets shot in the back by a cop when they had no gun.
Okay, so can I jump in here, Colonel? You mind?
Yeah, I'll take it after you.
All right. So all escalation of punitive decisions that the SASP makes is going to be left up to our colonel, our LT back here, and our captain, as well as Chief Ho. All I can do, if I'm on scene, and this is what all my good cops will be doing after they're trained correctly, will be reporting that to a supervisor like myself or Santana to my left. After that gets reported, we'll be using the chain of command to ensure that our recommendation is heard, but the ultimate decision will probably most likely be up to those three leaders that I just spoke about.
All right. Well, yeah, my main question is, will anything actually change in that area? Because that is one of the main issues that people are having with the city, is bad shit will happen and nothing will be done about it.
Yes. So going forward, there's going to be a three-strike policy. No more can we have it where officers, or at this point, troopers, allow themselves to do any wrongdoing on a traffic stop, or escalate it without a reason, or not being sensitive enough to the needs of those who are arrested. It is important to me that we have an understanding and a good relationship with our community, because it's a big deal that if you respect us and we respect you, that we can move forward with our day and not have to worry about anybody getting hurt on either side. So going forward, yes, there will be a disciplinary system, and if they do end up going too far in that disciplinary system, they will be removed of their status with the San Andreas State Police. They will lose their commission and badge, and they will be sent on their way with huge prejudice. We cannot be having people doing the same things that they were doing when the LSPD ran shit around here. The unprofessionalism will change. The way people talk to civilians while on duty would change. The way we handle certain scenes and other scenes differently is going to change. So going forward, to answer your question in short, yes.
Thank you.
Also, just to add on, moving forward, we'll make sure we have all refreshed our LSPD officers and some SASP officers with use of force policies, so we don't have any incidents in the future involving a cop potentially shooting someone in the back when, you know, they should have just tased them, or
I'm gonna agree with that.
Going over the use of force.
I'm agree.
Okay. All right, who's next?
Ernest was next.
Hello. Any one of you four?
Ernest.
Okay.
Are you shirtless? It's going to be a mix of both. It's also going to be a mix of utilizing the experience as a collective of the leadership that you see up here on the stage. So it's not just going to be a playbook out of my book. It's going to be a collective, agreed upon, and collaborative training SOP that we're going to be coming together as a group. I will have the pen and pad on that, though, and we'll be shooting over my draft sometime this weekend or early next week so that we can get this up and rocking.
Are you okay?
So use of force escalation's already been done. It just hasn't been trained. So that policy's already out there. What some of the techniques and procedures that the SASP is going to be using, it would behoove us to keep those close to chest, just based upon the dynamic that we have with some of the criminal organizations that run amok in the city. So I'm not trying to give out our playbook to everybody.
I can work with that.
Yeah, we can definitely do something like that. Colonel just said it.
Okay, give me one. Give me that question one more time, because my ears are deaf. Okay. Going forward, this will stand as the San Andreas State Police headquarters. We'll have a secondary headquarters in Palato up there at that other badge marked on your GPS. And then the one on the highway that replaced water treatment will be used primarily for heat when heat is necessary.
In the middle of a fucking conference.
That's all of them there. So we're still going to use assets as they're perfectly good. This is a perfectly good police station. There's nothing wrong with it. And going forward, we're going to use the shit out of it to be closer to our community that we plan to serve.
Okay, I would like to bring something up in case it is something serious here, not pertaining to my question, but all of the felonies / misdemeanors in the document placed in the emails is currently wiped. There is nothing on there. So if that's something SASP is working on, could you just let us know now?
That just goes to show how unprofessional and petty former Chief Taylor was. He didn't get his way, and he wasn't able to control the city in the way that he wanted to. And unfortunately, he has wiped our law book. So, yes, at this time, once we're done with this press meeting, all police officers are going to go off duty and work on that collaboratively with the agent to my right and the other FIB agent that walked out for government stuff. But yes, it'll be redone. Unfortunately, though, he thinks that he can start wiping shit and make us look like we don't know what we're doing. It won't work because we have backups of literally everything. So it was a good try,
Taylor K.
So it was a good try, but unfortunately, that's just not gonna fly.
And there's most likely more that's gonna be gone from Taylor. You guys haven't seen our emails as well.
If any of you are editors on that page, where you can actually edit it, you can undo anything he's done.
Yep.
I would like to ask.
All you have to do is hit the undo button.
Right. Okay. So who is next?
I believe it would be me. Unless it was the EMS.
What about him flapping his arms in front of
him? Go ahead and take that EMS. All
right, we'll take it EMS in the blue.
I just have a quick question. Okay. I was late to the party. Has there been a new chief instated or not?
The LSPD has been disbanded, and the San Andreas State Police is going to be your one and only police department serving your community.
Thank you.
Yep.
And ho.
What happened?
What?
I don't know. Who's next?
I just got a question real quick before I walk out. So somebody was on their private property and had a mask on their private property and was searched by an officer because they were on their private property with a mask on. Can you tell somebody they can't wear a mask at their own house?
Fourth Amendment rights unless it's a police investigation.
Excuse me. We have a situation right now. We have Flacco Mula on the large.
Well, that's actually what this is about right now, J-Hi.
Oh, for real?
So it's what he was arrested for. He was arrested because he was searched on his property with a mask on his property with no reason for Taylor to be there. Taylor's the one who searched him.
Chief, oh, deeper. The lore goes on.
If somebody can get a hold of him and let him know that Chief Taylor has been arrested, perhaps we can calm this down, as we don't want to hurt nobody or nobody else to get hurt by him.
Okay. All right, as long as Flacco's charges are dropped for that arrest, I think that would
be
okay.
It does sound like a violation of the Bill of Rights, and that'll be handled appropriately, as I stated earlier in the questioning here. Go ahead, Danger.
Yo, Jay.
Just wanted to make sure, you know, as far as, you know, we appreciate, of course, what y'all coming out and doing, especially, you know, as a fellow...
Negative. You know, he's out there hiding somewhere.
As a fellow...
No,
you know,
he's wearing a beanie.
Worker,
he's in
myself,
the building.
You know, me and my fellow...
He's in the building?
Workers,
what's he wearing?
Here, you know, we just want to make sure that, you know, as far as, you know, I know the professional working relationship that we've been developing with, you know, the state police, we just want to make sure that that's going to continue to develop and not have some of the issues that had pertained in the past. Of, you know, when medical is needed, not calling us, you know.
Correct. Going forward, there's going to be new department collaborated SOPs for that. I'll get with your chief and we'll work on that, because I do know that there's a couple of scenes where EMS got on rightfully yelled at for things that they had no control over because an officer had told them to do something. So, unfortunately, right now, it's going to be a lot of undoing what, or unfucking what they fucked. And I know that's on the bre- Is that Flacco right there?
Yeah, I would like to say I'm not at large.
Yeah, you're standing in front of me. Chief Taylor has been arrested and fired, and your charges will be dropped for that mask on your property.
Yeah, I would like
my
equipment back.
What did you have? Well, you know what? Talk to me afterwards. Let's finish the questions.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, I've got EMS stuff to do. I'll be back.
Yep.
Okay.
Batman, go ahead.
just about the training. I would hope that you will not be teaching your new troopers and rangers to fly like previously done, you know, because if I get tackled across a parking lot or tased from a mile away one more time, it's getting a little bit ridiculous, you know?
Yeah, J-Hi will handle that all in his training. Like I said, we will have a little declassified public version of it that's a little smaller in terms and such to handle that appropriately so that you guys can see what we're going through and what it takes to become a trooper, so that way you have the correct level of expectations for all of our troopers.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead, sir.
All right. I had an incident with J-Hi yesterday. My question is pertaining to this. Active scene control was very lackluster on his part. I was placed within feet of the person who had shot me, despite a full investigation not being thoroughly conducted. And he then proceeded to let the person who shot me go, despite dash cam and also store footage from ammunition proving that this guy had shot me off my bike. And also I'm still waiting for J-Hi to forward me the body cam of his interaction with that person in pertaining to the medical situation, the EMS, because I was not given medical attention until the brink of death. Precisely. I had lost so much blood and I had to go into emergency surgery at the hospital to remove bullets that EMS never checked me out for on scene.
Also,
despite J-Hi saying that EMS was contacted multiple times before.
I can attest to this. I have seen the body cam of what happened and what J-Hi was wrong. I don't know if he knew it was. Maybe he just, you know, he's had the criminal slip. But hopefully in the future, I'm going to let Ram talk in a minute, but hopefully in the future we can know, further get the training to the point where the investigations go a little bit more smoother and the right thing is done at the end of the scene. Hopefully that won't happen in the future. Ram, go ahead.
Yeah, so I think you and I talked via Zoom.
The emails.
Yeah. So even though he is the head of training at this moment, Sergeant Fawn will get with him and make sure that they're both on the same page when it comes to what's expected at scenes before any training or retraining of any officers conducts. And they'll both report to me on that. And then when they're both, you know, at about the place where I can feel confident to send them on the city or to train troopers to be out in the city, then they'll conduct the reformation and retraining of all troopers.
Yes. Speaking on that, I plan to have a meeting with the immediate supervisors tonight. As Jay High is our TO, our training officer. As we don't, not everybody's perfect, and as he stated before, it's going to be a collaborative playbook we're going to be forming. So that, okay. So this collaborative playbook, as I said, isn't going to be, as Jay High said, isn't going to be one of ours doing. It's going to be all of us coming together. And then once we get that approved by our command, then we'll go ahead and instate that and train the officers accordingly to what is expected by any law enforcement officer.
Gotcha. All right. I appreciate your guys' openness with the community holding this and sorting out the issues of the past.
Of course, brother. Of course.
Yes, sir. It's very important to us that we connect with our community in a positive manner. That way we can have a positive deal. Go ahead and ask your question there, Ernest.
You in jail? I want to beat the fuck out of you.
No. No, going into the future, he's going to go through a little bit of a stress management course. Anger management course. It does appear that tonight has stressed just about the entirety of the police department to the high max.
Literally flat.
I haven't been this stressed since I've done my combat tour in Syria. So, we're all a little bit on edge right now, and we're all gonna, you know, go to a meeting and sit down for a second and just air it out. Once everybody's done airing it out, we're gonna go ahead and sit down and stay there for a minute until everybody's breathing normal and calm, and then at that point we'll be confident enough to release troopers back into the city and get back to doing what we do best.
Speaking on that further, even though Jay High can be a little hot under the collar, and as Ram stated, stress management will be provided to him, he is more than capable and has proven many times that his leadership skills outshine even the command at some points. So that is why he was appointed to the position he's in as a training officer, because we feel that his leadership skills will shine through in the upcoming months, and we can practically, you know, rewrite all the wrongs that were done previously.
All right. I would like to applaud Jay High after the situation. Some fucking goons in rabbit mask were in a car driving by slow and shit. And then he pointed his gun at them just to give them the fuck off. So I appreciate that.
Like we stated multiple times here, we tend to we're going to make sure that the safety of the community is first and foremost. But at this time, if there is no more questions from the public, we will close this to the public and let Ernest finish up his thing here.
Yo, I got a question, actually.
Yes.
Okay.
Yo, my charges are being dropped, right?
I'm getting my money back for the incident
that happened with Taylor today.
For the Brian Taylor incident, yes. Yeah. Go ahead and make an admin ticket, and we'll have either the Marshall to my right handle it, Fawn to my left handle it, or myself, depending on availability.
All right.
Mm-hmm. All right, one last question, sir. Go ahead.
Me? Yeah, I had a question. You know, since Brian Taylor's arrested me a couple of times, can I get that, you know, off of my record?
We are willing to sit down and review claims of corruption from Brian Taylor or any of his officers.
I don't think it was corrupt. I just want to off my record because it makes me look bad.
I got that. If they're legitimate charges, then they're gonna stick. Which
yeah,
is
I think I wrapped the review. So. Didn't like that a lot.
Probably.
Right. Well, we can review some, but it, depending on how you know far the charge has gone, what kind of felony it is, we might not be able to help you out too much there.
All right. Have a good day, guys.
Yep.
My what?
You're halfway in the floor.
Yo, that's just how Rangers roll, sir.
Well, Ernest, if you're still getting this on camera, for people watching at home,
close to the ground.
We appreciate y'all for tuning in, and I know no one else is in the room, but all questions have been answered, and I hope that moving forward, we can better the SASP and have a good amount of troopers out, you know, protecting and serving the city as we need it. So thank you, everyone, for coming, and have a great night.
Final question.
Oh, one more question.
Since SASP is taking over the majority of law enforcement, will there still be or potentially be a sheriff's office in... Okay. Can you hear me?
Yep. I can hear you the whole time.
Will there be a sheriff's office implemented into the city or no?
At this time, due to either the general public not being friendly or previous leadership, it's been a hell of a time keeping troopers and officers as it is. So going forward, we're going to make sure that we're properly staffed to handle the state before we worry about any other departments. As
will
you
it
can
potentially
see
be in the future?
It's potentially something we can look at. As you can see, the two departments that we had didn't quite work out so well. Right. So,
just wondering if I can cosplay.
Right, yeah. It's something we definitely want to look into at some point. I just don't know how near or far that will be.
Yeah, so as I stated, the more people we have in SASP, the more we grow the community as far as PD goes. Potentially in the future, we can most definitely put something together, but first we just need to have that staff in SASP and get them rolling in the right
hey
direction
guys, crypto
first.
Up good right now. Invest.
Okay, any last questions?
Can I give the lieutenant a hug?
Oh, that's his discretion. He's more than happy to give you a hug and give him a hug. He's got to figure out the rope first. Give him a second. Ernest, if you'd like any further private questions, I'm more than happy to answer them. What? Yes, trooper.
I'm going to get out of here so I can cry.
Thank you for your service.
Do I look good?
That'd be look great, brother. Looking real good.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Shut up.
Okay. Anything further that you need, you can just hit me up.
Chris, you need to leave.
Once I approve that, I'll have Jay High get in contact with you and give you the public version of it, as we do want to keep some of our trainings a little more on the private side because. So some things that, like police systems and stuff, is not something that we necessarily want the public to know about.
All right, can you help me clear everybody out? Let's start clearing everybody out.
Yeah, let's go.
Right, yep, so. Yeah, so we'll push it out to you as soon as we have it approved and ready to go. Okay, what do you need exactly in the Discordia? Because Tom can probably handle that right now.
Okay. Okay, can you go in the emails and DM me really fast? I should be a government Tom. You should be able to find me in there. And I'll fix that for you. All right, brother. Appreciate that.
Yep. You have a good night. All right, let's clear people out of my department. I'm going to go de-escalate myself and...
I've got some things you gotta take care of in my head.
Alrighty, Mr. Superintendent.
I think
that trooper out there is a little sexist.
Yeah, I think he's a little bit biased.
No, I'm making a statement.
Come on. Can you guys please make your way outside?
Hey, record this, Ernest. Record this. Get this on videotape.
I'm an ASAP. I need help ASAP.
Ernest, are you recording this? I'm about to make a statement. I would like to say that the trooper out there is highly sexist. He is only supporting Scar's coffee shop, but he won't support my fight club because I am a man. And I think that trooper is highly sexist. And this is all the time I have. Thank you for your time. I will talk to you later.
Get the building.
Let's go. Let me talk to that trooper
first. Shut up. I can't get out. It's locked.
It was that one, Ernest. That's the sexist right there.
But I hold doors open.
Leave immediately.
And you're here, twin. Yo, then a young boy go dumb, no cap.
But I mean, hey, get me in here.
If you wait, then I'm about it. Alright, guys, get off the property, please.
Shut up, nerd!
Can't go on your bike. Is it a two-seater? I don't know.